Knock, knock. Hello, H cuties. Notice anything different? It's me, the Brick Bob Barker, the minifig Martindale, the lagging Lego Scott Brickowski, live from Bricksburg, bringing you our most creative quiz yet, an HQ special event. Presented by my friends in the Lego Movie 2, the second part, baby. In theaters Thursday. That's tomorrow. Tomorrow, guys. I hope you're all doing well on this Wednesday night. We're making not only quistery, but showbiz history. They turned me into a Lego, people. This don't happen every day. What do you think? I spent 5 minutes choosing my hair. I'm pretty happy with it. Got this sweet Guy Fieri beard going, and I'm live. I can see all of you in the chat right now. Tammy72 says, Scott's a Lego. Yeah, I'm a Lego. I could go 360, baby. What do you think? Feels like I'm wearing nothing at all. Nothing at all. Nothing at all. What do you want me to do? You want me to stick on my tongue? Put the tongue in the emoji, the tongue emoji in the chat right now. The Jew Baller says, Scott is so cool. I was a Jew Baller too. I appreciate you. Let me see that tongue. Let me see that tongue in the emoji in the chat there. Okay, here it is. Arlan wanted it. Chris is 16. My tongue is sticking out. How about a leg kick? Look at this. What's under there? Some kind of, oh my God, are there numbers on there? I got thumbprints. Thumbprints on me? I don't like this. Can we get a moist towel? Can we clean myself up? Look, I tried to pick my nose, but I can't. I don't have nostrils, guys. Hey, look, we're making things extra awesome tonight on HQ with a jacked up jackpot and a special collectible prize. If you answer all 15 questions, you'll be building a nest egg brick by brick with part of our $75,000 pot. Yeah, that's enough to treat yourself to a hot gem massage. And 5 lucky winners will be walking away with limited edition collectible capsules that are only available here. That was the HQ an exclusive. Hey, season 2 of HQ is in full swing, which means you can also win points along the way with every question you answer, all right? And those translate to levels, of course, which earn you free passes. And those can help you win tonight and every night in season 2, up to our season finale, which grows by the day with all the points you collectively earn. Let's check in on that right now, our season finale jackpot. What do we got? What do we got? 63,000. I see you all out there in the Sistar system. Can you survive our Momageddon tonight? Are you couching for an ouchin'? Look, this quiz is gonna get stuck inside your head. I'm never gonna get tired of this dance. Look, I can go to the side. Want me to do the limbo? Oh, bend over to the flow. Touch your toes. Yeah, not that flexible, even in Lego form. Huh. You guys ready to put your hands together, and then apart, and then together again, all 600,000 of you live around the world? What do you say we get this show on the road, Sparkle Babies? Let's go, Legos. You like those little avatars there? Yeah, who's Metal Beard tonight? Spaceman? Let's get down to the nitty-bricky with over 600,000 HQTs around the world live with me in Lego form. Let's get this Lego show on the road, baby. It's HQmero numero uno. A popular song from the Lego movie asserts that everything is what? Awesome, gluten-free, or password-protected? Come on, you heard the song in the promos, in the intro tonight, in the lobby. You couldn't escape it when the first film came out. And spoiler alert, it's getting a remix in the new movie. Everything is awesome. Everything is cool when you're part of a team. 525,671 of you are off to an awesome start tonight for Q2. What catchphrase was popularized by comedian Tiffany Haddish? She ready, you got mail, or it's a me, Mario. It's a me, Mario. That's an 80s thing, man. You've got mail, that's a 90s thing. But Tiffany burst onto the scene in a big way just a couple of years ago with this catchphrase / life mantra.
Who is she? She's a Lego.
Whatever Wanabe in a Lego Movie 2, 419 got that right. A couple of you there, 100,000 plus. I hope you got your free passes to keep you in this game. Are you ready for Q3? I'm ready to go to the hospital after this game. I think I broke my arm. Q3, what is the name of large Lego pieces designed for smaller kids? Pinto, Duplo, or Bilbo?
Is it Duplo? I think so.
That's Duplo, not Diplo, okay? Diplo's something else. Traditional Lego pieces can be pretty, pretty petite, all right? AKA easy to swallow. So it was a smart decision by Lego Brad to introduce
my internet.
Small hands, kind of like mine.
You missed me.
No, I did not. I'm talking Duplo, released in 1969. Happy 50th anniversary, Duplo. 444,509 of you building your way to Q4 in this special event show. How about this, guys? Live Lego 3D. This is crazy. I'm losing my mind a little bit. Q4. The members of the Lonely Island work together on what TV show? Mad TV, Saturday Night Live, or In Living Color? They've since added numerous producing, writing, directing, and acting credits to their resume, including collaborating on Everything That's Awesome and a new song, Super Cool, in the Lego Movie 2. But the Lonely Island got their start live from New York. It's Saturday Night. Saturday Night Live, not Saturday and Live. 280,769 got this one right. It's not a lazy Wednesday for you. You're on a boat right now to Q5. Which of these is not a profession held by a Chris Pratt movie character? Pet detective, Navy SEAL, or baseball player?
Chris,
of course, voices my cousin, Tennant Brickhouse. Dwight Parks and Rec, but on the big screen, he was a Navy SEAL in Zero Dark Thirty and Scott Hatterberg, a baseball player with a great eye, in Moneyball, great on-base percentage. For pet detecting, that's Jim Carrey's domain. 265,522. This house is clear. You got this one right. 150,000 out. You didn't see Moneyball? Come on, get your extra lives to keep you in this game. 111,000 out. Baseball player. Come on. Moneyball. That's like my Star Wars. That's my Lego. Q6. The original sketch came from a sketch by whom? Leonardo da Vinci, Isaac Newton, or Galileo Galilei?
Anyone?
Three famously creative thinkers here.
Not me.
But only one put down plans on paper for a kind of flying machine called an ornithopter, which inspired the design of Batman's big cape. He also inspired a Ninja Turtle. I'm talking Leonardo da Vinci. Leonardo from Vinci. 207,918 are going to be flying on to Q7. But before we get there, have you folks heard the word about HQ Words?
Where you spin a wheel and solve word puzzles to win cash. Tap the button below to get notified when it's live. It's easy. If you know how to spell, then you know how to win. Words is up next, right after trivia.
That's right, Anna Royton, host of HQ Words. Words is immediately following HQ tonight with a very special offer here. 10,000 points going to you. By playing HQ Words, just spin the wheel, join the game, 10,000 points, just like that. Those points are going to help you level up, guys. Maybe they're going to help you get to level 7. Anybody at level 7 yet? We're at Q7 right here. Lego bricks were invented in what country? The Netherlands, Denmark, or Australia?
Denmark, right?
Oh, 208,000 of you still in this to win this $75,000. You know, I may be in Oz right now bringing you this groundbreaking live 3D animated experience. Huh? Here's the tongue again. But the Lego origin story begins far from here. Far from probably where you are, too. It should come as no surprise. Lego was born in the happiest country on Earth. Denmark. Land of Carlsberg, Niels Bohr, and Hans Christian Andersen. Anderson, that's me, 159,223. You know your Lego history. I have a follow-up question for you then at Q8. The name Lego is derived from what two Danish words? Happy bricks, build fun, or play well?
Not me.
We had over 600,000 of you joining us live to start this show. 160,000 remain. Lego inventor Ole Kurt Christensen named his toys, originally made of wood rather than plastic, after the abbreviation of words le and go in his native Danish, meaning play well. Play well is your answer. 88,860 playing extremely well tonight on this HQ special event presented by the Lego Movie 2. You're getting a leg up on the competition, feeling fine for Q9. Which of these fashion designers is famous for popularizing the punk look? Betsy Johnson, Tom Ford, or Vivian Westwood? This question is a nod to Lucy, who reveals her true wild style and punk aesthetic in the new movie. There likely wouldn't be a punk aesthetic as we know it today without this creative visionary, who has pushed the fashion envelope since the early 70s. I'm talking about Vivian Westwood. Go West, young men and women. 50,282 want NRK. NRK in the HQK. You're getting Q10. Who supplied key building material for the construction of the original Yankee Stadium? Howard Hughes, Henry Ford, or Thomas Edison? Three major creators of the 19th and 20th centuries, Howard Hughes, influential in the aviation industry, Ford in the automobile industry, of course, and Thomas Edison, who said, "Let there be electric light." But Edison also invested and innovated in the cement business, and his company provided the concrete for Yankee Stadium. In 1922, Thomas Edison is your answer. 29,065. This is the quiz that you guys built. Yankee Stadium should have been called the house that Edison built. Forget Babe Ruth. $75,000 is what you're building towards tonight. $75,000 plus those limited edition Lego collectible caps that you cannot get anywhere else. Let me stress that, folks. Five of you will be randomly selected for that incredible prize. Completely rare, never seen before, put together just for you on this special event here in HQ. You got a few questions left to get there. Q11. The Guinness World Record for largest Lego structure features what landmark? Tower Bridge, Empire State Building, or Taj Mahal? Nearly 6 million individual Lego bricks were used to create this 43-foot high replica in 2016. If laid end to end, they'd stretch almost 200 miles. How's that? You want me to wink? Hey, the chat wants me to wink. I'm winking at this answer right here. 200 miles, that's a distance equivalent to going from Paris to the actual Tower Bridge in London Town. Which is what the record-breaking Lego structure was fashioned after. Tower Bridge is your answer. Oh, that London Bridge is falling for 8,000 of you who fell out of the quiz, but 26,742. I'll wink at you. I'll give you a nod. How's that? A wink and a nod to Q12. I can't really, you know, these Lego heads. I can, I gotta see a chiropractor about this after the show. Q12. Which of these authors wrote far more novels than the other two? Alexandre Dumas, Jane Austen, or Charles Dickens? We are getting lit on Lego Night. A literary question. You don't necessarily need bricks to create. You can simply use pen and paper. For raw creative output, it's hard to top this outrageously prolific author who wrote at least 50 novels and many other works. It's Mr. Three Musketeers himself, Alexandre Dumas. Ooh, 21,124 remain after that one. My HQDs in the Iron Mask. You want to see me raise my brows? How about I clench them first? And then I open them real wide. Huh? I told you, I'm live, 3D. We're not kidding around here, guys. This has never been done before at this scale. We got Q13 right now. Just three questions left. What is the name of the first ever Lego computer game released in the U.S.? Lego Island, Lego Racers, or Lego Creator? Ugh. Lego heads don't need me to tell them that the first ever Lego video game was Lego Fun to Build, released in 1995 for the Sega Pico in Japan. But U.S. Lego lovers? Well, you had to wait for Lego Island to appear on Microsoft Windows.
The only way to visit Lego Island is to become a Lego person.
You got to become a Lego person like me. Yes, 1997, Lego Island, and 21,375. Islands unto themselves. You guys are good. You know your Legos. You want that $75,000? And five, you really want that collectible limited edition capsule. I know you do. We're at the penultimate question right now. Q14. Which of these classic 80s songs repeatedly mentions a 1909 Nobel Prize winner? We built this city, We Didn't Start the Fire, or The Final Countdown? Uh-oh. I'm seeing a lot of you in the chat right now. Want me to dab? You want me to floss? Look, I have limited mobility. I was doing my calisthenics. How's that for a dab? As I can't quite cross. You gotta. All right, we're gonna work. I'm gonna work on my dabbing skills. Billy Joel worked on his name-checking skills in this classic song, We Didn't Start the Fire. But is that the answer? Well, he mentions Einstein and Hemingway. Never repeatedly, and none of them won a Nobel in 1909. That distinction belongs to Guglielmo Marconi. Guglielmo Marconi, father of radio. Shouted out in the hook on Starships. We built this city. We built this city on rock and roll. Marconi playing the mamba and 17,387 joining him. Playing that mamba because you're one question away, baby. One question away from 75K and those collectible capsules. It's Q15 on this special HQ event. It all bricks up to this. It all builds up to this brick by brick by brick. Look at that special Lego graphic with our brick 15. How about that? Shout out our graphics. Question 15. Oh, mama. What is the newest color introduced to the Lego brick palette? Bright violet, vibrant coral, or light nougat? The newest, and I'm talking brand spanking new, because this color was introduced for the Lego Movie 2, and it's featured in 2019 Lego sets. Yes, you can go out and get them right now. Did you catch the press releases in November? Are you an active member on the Lego fan forums? Only the real ones will know this one. The name of that new salmon shade is Vibrant Coral. Vibrant Coral's the answer. 10,363 H cuties are our big Lego winners. Baby! Vibrating with love and light, with vibrant coral. Everything is spectacularly, extremely awesome for the 10,363 of you who won that. And five of you are going to win something that money cannot buy. Those collectible capsules. So stay tuned. You'll be hearing from HQ. But in the meantime, you got $7.24 for your troubles. How about that, folks? An ultimate Lego fan bragging rights. No one can say they know Lego better than you do. Talking Mike. Megan, You Can't See, Moai Again, Happy Steve, Greg Take, Go Blue Rules, Five Night Bite. For $7.24, depending on where you live, of course, you can probably buy a ticket to the Lego Movie 2 right now with your winnings. I mean, look, New York, okay, get find some kind of discount code, all right, and get that ticket in advance. But if you're out there in Bozeman, maybe Dayton, Ohio, you could probably afford a $7 movie ticket. Lego Movie 2, of course, in theaters tomorrow. I've seen it. I loved it. Congrats to all of you who won tonight. The teacher has become the teaching assistant. I'm going to do a little celebration dance for all of you right now. Share your results to get more points. Of course, you won points along the way. Thanks to our partners, Warner Brothers and Lego Movie 2. Second part, don't touch that dial, guys. HQ Words is popping up right now with Anna Roisman, and we're giving you 10,000 points just for playing the game. So keep your phone closed. You don't have to close out. You don't have to go anywhere else. It's right there. It's the same map. It's wonderful. What a show, huh? We made history tonight. I could get these thumbprints off me. I don't know who was putting me together, but they got some pretty cool prints there. I'm going to be hanging out in Bricksburg for a while, taking a little holiday down under. Until I see you all again, Scott Brokowski here. Signing off, saying, stay awesome, baby! Everything is awesome! Everything is cool when you're part of a team. Hey, HQ Words! Woo.